hi. Just say everything you'll need will be written underneath, and please just follow the manufacturer's instructions for cooking and whatever you do. This is another kind of scrap challenge. Now, yesterday I did a pet memorial tutorial and I had quite a bit of scrap left over, so I thought, especially with it being white, I thought, what can I do? So I actually don't know for sure what I'm going to do yet. I just thought I'm going to video it and see what happens. But what I've done for now is I've collected all of the white clay. It had some gold flecks in, but it wasn't enough that it looked like it was meant to be there, so I've actually added another sheet of gold. So it's white, but it's just sort of got that gold speckle. Okay, so then I thought I'm going to play with alcohol inks a little bit. So I thought I'm going to texture this, but I'm not just going to texture it. I want to texture it at the same time as we're putting foil on. I haven't done it before. I've obviously seen it somewhere. So that's what I'm going to do now. So this is rolled out on the number two, the scraps from yesterday, and I'm going to apply, I've got some silver foil here, I'll try and apply it in one. Whether it will or not is another matter, as most of it's gone on there. Okay, and if I take you off, I must stop talking to these inanimate objects. Overlapped a bit there, but I'm sure it will sort itself. Right, I'm going to just burnish it. We can sort out what's what. It's a little bit messy at the moment. Some excess here, so where am I going to stick that? Let me just get it off. Right. See if I can brush this away a little bit so it doesn't start flying everywhere. Okay, I'll clean the rest up in a minute. Now I've got the foil down and I want to texture it, but I don't want the foil going into the texture sheet, so I'm going to lay some cling film over now. Okay, then I'm going to place the texture sheet on top, and I'm going to have to stand up to do this. Let's hope I've done enough. It's not as deep as I wanted it to be. I wonder whether to redo it. out. I'm going to take a chance here and go over it again. I don't know whether the cling film is making it harder or whether I just didn't push in there. This is where it can go wrong, isn't it? Oh, it's moving. Nope. Oh, that's better than it was. So now, hopefully there's enough crevices that the alcohol ink can swim around. So I'm just wondering whether to put some alcohol down first or not. See how it goes on its own first. So I've chosen a lilac purple, a much darker rich purple, a light blue, sort of a turquoise blue, it's called Stream, and a Panatta magenta. So they're the colours I've chosen. So we'll see what happens. Now I've got two options here. I can either slice off the top of the silver now and then add the alcohol inks, or I can add them and sort of see if I get some sort of dichotomic effect. Do you want me to do half and half? That can be an experiment then, can't it? Just want to get the right blade. Right, so on this, where's the thickest? This side, it's only really here. But here, on the thickest areas, or the highest areas, I'm just going to gently peel the pattern off. You can see how different the effect is, and then you can see which you prefer. So this half I'll leave silver. Some of it went in thicker than the rest, so I don't know how much will show. I'm going to finish doing this side off camera because I'm trying to shorten my videos a bit, and if I'm dilly dallying, I'll come back when I've done this side. Okay, so I've taken away the shavings of the texture from this side as best I can. I've just cut around the edges just to tidy it up. I'm going to put a couple of finger cots on. It's going to be a waste of time. I'm going to get covered, but fingers crossed. Wouldn't do much with my fingers crossed, would I? I'm going to start with, I'm not going to put any alcohol on yet. I'm going to start with the light and dark lilac. I bought some inks, and the inks are absolutely great from company, but the bottles, three of them now, I've had to redo like this because the lids just jam. But I thought this one had as well then. Oh, it has. Don't tell me that. Have I got another light purple? Let me just check. Closest I've got is a violet, which I don't think is much lighter than that. This was the only one that hadn't done it. Right. Well, I'm just going to have to leave that out then. It won't be in there. Because I think that violet is a little bit too between those two. Okay. I'll start with the darkest colour first. It would be fun to do both. I mean, I don't know how different they'll even look, but I thought at least this way you can see which looks the best. It's more than enough for now, I think. That's supposed to be a rich purple, but I always think it's got more of a bluey tone to it. Then I'm going to add a bit of this one, which is Rangers. What I'll do is, as I'm not adding that lilac, I might add some pearl. I may end up going to find another colour, we'll see. Like, this is Bluebird by Resin 8. I might add a bit of alcohol ink to this, I'll see how it goes. I'm trying not to overdo it, because that's so easy to do, isn't it? This is the magenta, which always steals the show. It's so strong. Missing that pearl. Put a little bit more of this stream on. And a little bit more of this light blue, and then I'm wondering whether to squeeze a little bit of alcohol ink on, see what happens. Starting to spread now. It's going to need lightening up though, so I hope my pearls are going to do good. A little bit more magenta. Oh, that's the pearl. What am I doing? Oh, well, at least it's working. I thought I'd picked up the alcohol ink. Actually, that could be my cue to use this. So, oh, it's great. Now I've shook it, it's not going to work. Oops, that came out a bit too much. Come on, don't blame your hat. I don't know if it would be like the metallic ones where it doesn't spread the same. Well, that's looking pretty. Certainly brought the colour down. And I don't think there's going to be that much difference between the two where I sliced it off. Oh, I'm loving the colours there. I don't know if you can see it. See if I can, if I zoom in. I must remember to zoom out. If you can see them, they're fuzzing away there. Yeah, you can see it on the screen. A bit more there. On that while it's doing it. Match. Nothing this when it's coming out. I think I'm going to be at risk of totally oversaturating this soon, so I need to slow down. Okay, well, I'm going to leave this to dry and then I'll be back. Hi, so the scrap clay's more or less dry now. I don't want to dome anything on this occasion, and I don't want it around the edges, so I am just going to cut whatever needs cutting on here and then just stick them straight in the oven. Shoo, let's see what we've got room for. Right, I'm going to cut that one. And similar impressions. Oh, and another. I'll try and have the same colours in there because sometimes they can end up looking quite different and then that doesn't work too well. I've made that mistake a few times even though it's the same piece. Just gone and used the same earring thing twice, but that doesn't matter. That one, and we'll match that with. See, no, some light blue in it. Looking for the better bits. There, that'll do. I want to resin these afterwards, so that's why I've decided to keep them flat and not edge them. Just want to do them simple. And I think I can have enough to do the right other earring for that. Or am I? See how it goes. Right. Let's do one of these there. Oops. Wasn't a good move, was it? The disadvantage of not using cling film. It's probably going to do it again now. Just seeing if there's an area that will. Probably there might be the best place. That one stayed in, and now I've got enough room to do one of these with the other one, but I don't know whether it's going to match enough. I'd never think to look and see if my earrings were the opposites were different. It just wouldn't occur to me. It's only since doing this that I've even realised. So hmm. some white bits, they don't look too good. I'll see if I can do it without them. Let's do that one there and see what happens. Okay, so I'm gonna put these. Ooh. Into the oven at the manufacturer's recommended temperatures. I'll just show you them first. Pre-bake. That one's oh dear. No, I'm going to leave that in for now. Sort it after. As long as they're the same. Yeah, so I'm just going to put these in to bake, and I'm also going to rebake them with the backs on. I'm only going to do it on a number 5, so it's really fine because they're earrings, with the rest of the scrap clay. So when I come back, they'll be baked this side and I'll have done the back. Okay, so I'll see you in a minute. Hi, so I'm back and they're out of the oven. I'll show you them close up at the moment. That's what they look like now. And I put a back on a number 5. I literally rolled up the skeleton edge in from where I cut the pieces out, and I just rolled that with texture. I'm not sure whether I'll put any silver on it yet or leave it. I'll see how the front goes first. So the first thing I want to do is I'm doing exactly the same on all of them. So I'll just do it with one to show you. So the first thing I want to do now is I want to drill a hole for the top of this before I resin it. I just find it's easier because you can often get that little crackle just around the resin hole. I do it both ways, but I think if you can do it this way. Okay. So, you've got your hole. Right. The next thing I'm going to do is resin it. So let me just put it on here. Not to overdo it. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to bring everything into the middle so I can see it's all done. If it does cover the hole, it's not the end of the world, but if you can manage to resin around it, it's great. Which at the moment, I think I've put a little bit too much on to manage to go around it, but never mind, we'll still be able to drill through it. So just need to check the outside edge now. Let me just look at it under the light. Hopefully you can see it as well. Just make sure I haven't missed any. Okay. So now I'm just going to go over that with the lighter to get rid of any bubbles. Then I'm going to put this and the other ones into the UV resin machine, and then I'll be back and we can look at the findings. Okay. Hi, so I've resined everything and I've just put this earring, a pinch bell, straight through the drilled hole at the top. I've drilled another hole in the bottom, and also on the internal piece I've drilled a hole. So now I'm just going to add these together. I'm not going to do them all, I'm just going to do this one because every single one of them are done in more or less the same way, certainly the same technique, just different beads. So first of all, I'm going to form a loop and then I'm going to bend it back. I'll bring it round. So I've got my loop, and then I'm going to add, is it silver first? The silver, you know, obviously you choose your own beads, your own colour combinations to go whatever inks you chose, but this is how I do it. I've got the finger cots on because of the resin, as like I said, I've got some sort of bloody genetic problem when it comes to putting my fingers where they shouldn't go, like that in craft. That didn't sound right, did it? I do mean in craft. Right, so that's done there. It's going to be that way. So I'm just going to insert this jump ring. I always know with me, it's to the left, I always go from front to back, so then I always know this is the piece that's straight. It's just a habit thing. I forget once in a while, but it's generally what I do. And then I'll hold that up straight and bring that one back up to it. Okay, and if you possibly can, always put your hooks in the clay. Sometimes the hole's too loose to keep it there, but it's just another thing that helps secure everything. So now that I've made that, I'm just going to open that up to allow that in. Shut it, and like I said, I've done exactly the same with all the other ones. I just varied where I put the beads, and obviously you put slightly different beads, but otherwise it's exactly the same. Which is that, now that's that way, which means that has to go in that way. Now I've just got to flatten this back down. What are you doing? Now I just got to flatten that back down, and then we can complete that pair of earrings. Like I said, I've done the others. So we've got these. We've got these where I put the beads on the top. Exactly the same, just the other way. And then I had these ones as well, didn't I? So I've just did one bead with these. So let me just put one of each and take these off now. And I'll just put one of each in my hand so you can see it more closely. One, two, three. So there's the three pairs of earrings, all from the scrap from the memorial pendant I did yesterday. But I don't know if you can see the colours, but they really are nice. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you.